Winds are high and summer days are few. Green fields have turned to gold. The time is here for the harvesting, for gathering home into barns. The harvest is plenty, laborers are few. Your arms may grow weary, your shoes will wear thin. Come with me into the fields.
The seeds were sown by other hands than yours. Nurtured and cared for, they grow. But the reaping will not be their care.
The harvest is plenty, laborers are few. Come with me into the fields. Your arms may grow weary, your shoes will. The kingdom of heaven is here. The harvest is plenty, laborers are few. Come with me into the fields. Your arms may grow weary, your shoes will wear thin.
Good evening and welcome to St. John the Evangelist Parish on this 25th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please rise and join singing our opening song, We Gather Together.
And hastens in. In the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord Jesus, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you. Good evening.
Good evening,
and welcome to all, especially any guests that join us. A special welcome to Tim and Nancy's family as they celebrate their 50th wedding anniversary this evening. We do so as the Word of God reminds us that if we wish to be first, we must be last. And so for the times we prided ourselves on being number one, for the times we have sinned, we ask God's forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts we may merit to attain eternal life. This we ask through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The wicked say, "Let us beset the just one because he is obnoxious to us. He sets himself against our doings, reproaches us for transgressions of the law, and charges us with violations of our training. Let us see whether his words be true. Let us find out what will happen to him. For if the just one be the Son of God, God will defend him and deliver him from the hand of his foes. With revilement and torture, let us put the just one to the test, that we may have proof of his gentleness and try his patience. Let us condemn him to a shameful death, for according to his own words, God will take care of him." The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Beloved, where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there is disorder in every foul practice. But the wisdom from above is first of all pure, then peaceable, gentle, compliant, full of mercy and good fruits, with inconstancy or insincerity. And the fruits of righteousness is sown in peace for those who cultivate peace. Where do the wars and where do the conflicts among you come from? Is it not from your passions that make war within your members? You covet but do not possess. You kill and envy but you cannot obtain. You fight and wage war. You do not possess because you do not ask. You ask, but you do not receive, because you ask wrongly to spend it on your passions. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
gives our spirit and life. You have the words of everlasting life.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus and his disciples left from there and began a journey through Galilee. But Jesus did not wish anyone to know about it. He was teaching his disciples and telling them, "The Son of Man is to be handed over to men, and they will kill him. And 3 days after his death, the Son of Man will rise." But they did not understand the saying, and they were afraid to question him. They came to Capernaum, and once inside the house, he began to ask them, "What were you arguing about on the way?" But they remained silent. They had been discussing among themselves on the way who was the greatest. Then Jesus sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "If anyone wishes to be first, he shall be last of all and servant of all." Taking a child, he placed it in their midst, and putting his arms around the child, he said to them, "Whoever receives one child such as this in my name receives me. And whoever receives me receives not me, but the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord. So when I want to chill out, I turn to a favorite music station, 106.9. In Milwaukee, it is the Oldie Goldie station, playing music from the 60s and 70s, 60, 70 years old, years ago, very nostalgic music. It's sort of interesting how a song can take you back to a place, a person, actually the emotion you were feeling when you first heard that song. But in addition to playing Oldie Goldie music, they also play the advertisements that were being advertised on that station 60 and 70 years ago. And there's one of my favorite ads takes place in Indiana. And I don't remember all the details, so I sort of added my own details. But it takes place. Gusty Miller from Huntington, Indiana, wins the blue ribbon for her apple pie entrance into the pie contest. And so they're interviewing Gusty Miller, her blue ribbon apple pie, for like the 40th time. And this time it's because she changed her ingredient to a new Crisco cream, new Crisco lard, new Crisco. And why did you do that, Mrs. Miller? "Because it makes the crust so delicious and so flaky. And just look at the beautiful brown, toasty brown crust, pie crust. It makes for the most perfect pie." So just think a moment how Gusty Miller feels so much success being the number one pie winner at the Indiana State Fair. There must be thousands of other pie entries, and here she's number one. And not only this year is she number one, but she is on this radio station at WOWO from Fort Wayne, Indiana, just down the road from Huntington, Indiana. So just think of all the jealousy of her Sodality women friends Gusty Miller winning again 40 years in a row. Fact is, we're all a little bit like Gusty Miller. We all want to be number one, maybe not making pie crust. Academics, we like to be number one. Years ago when I was in school, every student was their listing, their rating from 1 to 1,000 was there. If sports, everyone wants to be number one sports, no matter if it's football or basketball or soccer. We want to be the greatest quarterback. We want to be the greatest receiver. We want to be the greatest goalie. And Jesus turns this all upside down today in today's gospel. He asked the disciples, he asked the apostles, he asked the 12, well, what were you discussing on the way? As if he didn't know what they were discussing. Well, Lord, we were discussing who is the greatest among us? Who's the greatest apostle? Who's the smartest? Who's the strongest? Who's the most faithful one? And Jesus says, you're getting it wrong. If you want to be number one, it's not by your strength, it's not by your intelligence, but it's by your willingness to serve, your willingness to die to yourself in order to love God and to love others. A perfect example was Thursday's gospel. It was Mary Magdalene, heard Jesus in town at the Pharisee's house. She went into the house. She starts weeping on his feet and then takes her hair and uses her hair as a towel to wipe up the tears. And on Thursday, I was just mentioning how important our hair is. No matter if we have a lot of hair or a little hair, we all are concerned about hair. Just think about the amount of money we put into hair, the amount of color we put into hair, the amount of style we put into hair. My mother went to the beauty parlor every Friday for 20 years, and she'd get home, and before bed, she'd put on her bed headpiece, plastic cap to make sure her investment would last another day, maybe 2 days, get me through the weekend so everybody can see my beautiful hair. But here's this woman, Mary Magdalene, weeping and using her beautiful hair as a towel. And Jesus says, here's a woman who loves greatly. Here is a woman who serves, who will be number one. Not because she has the most beautiful hair, but because she uses her hair in the most humbling of ways. Today's gospel of Jesus challenging the apostles, who is greatest, turns the thought of the world upside down. It isn't the wealthiest, it isn't the strongest, it isn't the smartest, it could be all three of those, but it is the one who is willing to serve. Gusty Miller won the blue ribbon on her apple pie. It'd be a great service to all that she would serve each of us a piece of that pie as service of serving the people in her neighborhood, those people who would enjoy a piece of Huntington apple pie. May we learn from Jesus and also serve each other with whatever gifts and talents we have been given. So we rise as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of
Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. Even the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead. To God, who desires to give us the fullness of life, we pray our needs in confidence.
For Pope Francis, Archbishop Listecki, and all the baptized, that we may be servants of one another, particularly for those in need, and thus bear witness to God's love for everyone, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a spirit of humility, that we may recognize all our gifts as gifts from God, and our need for one another to become our fullest selves, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For spiritual freedom, that God will awaken us to selfishness and disordered desires that distract us, and help us choose ways to be instruments of God's mercy and compassion, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace of conversion, that God will help us to curb our passions of envy and the desires to possess, so that we will be free to live peaceably and with gratitude for all that God has given us, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing and strength, that the good news of the dying and rising of Jesus may bring hope to the sick and strength to those who care for them, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace, that God will open hearts to dialogue about the issues that cause warfare and terrorism, guide the advancement of justice, and protect the innocent from harm, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Jace Oberlander, who will be baptized this weekend, and for his family, and for the 50th wedding anniversary of Tim and Nancy Janusko, for whom this Mass is offered, and for those intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray.
Lord, hear
our prayer. Almighty God, you sent your Son Jesus as a servant who died that our sins may be forgiven. May we follow his example. We ask this and all our needs through Christ, our risen Lord.
Christ to you.
day, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good
of all his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what we profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, in Jesus you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us a share in his fullness. For though he was in the form of God, he emptied himself, and by the blood of his cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore he has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing your praise. You are indeed holy, O Lord. You are the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time Jesus was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice once more, giving thanks. He gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until
therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity. Together, Francis, our Pope, Jerome, our Archbishop, and all the clergy, Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord Jesus always be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other some sign of God's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Bless those called to share in the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word.
Look beyond the
The Religious Ed Parent Meeting will be on Tuesday night, September 24th. Specifics are in the bulletin. Parents, don't forget to register your children on the St. John's website. Classes are free to attend. St. John's Young Adult Group, Rooted, is hosting a soccer golf night on September 28th. Single and married adults between the ages of 18 and 35 are welcome to attend this free event. Please RSVP by September 26th. Informational flyers are in the narthex. Script will be sold after all masses this weekend.
Let us pray. God, our Creator, graciously raise up those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of heavenly hosts, by the power of God, Mary, Mother of the Eucharist.
Pray for us.
We'd like to send Tim and Nancy off with a special blessing if you wish to come forward to receive your anniversary blessing. I invite the congregation to join me in blessing this couple by extending your right hands as I pray the blessing prayer. Loving, gracious God, we bless and praise your name. In the beginning, you created man and woman so that they might enter a communion of life and love. You have blessed the union of Tim and Nancy so that they may reflect the union of Christ with his church. We pray this evening, look with kindness on them. Amid the joys and struggles of their life, you have preserved the union between them. We pray you renew their marriage covenant, increase your love in them, strengthen their bond of peace, so that with family and friends, they may always rejoice in the gift of your grace. We ask this blessing through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And Tim, you may kiss your bride. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Solemn vow to take.